What about me? What about me? What about me and you together?
Nobody likes me. I have no friends. I'm useless.
Seem a little crazy, pretty baby, but I promise mama's gonna be alright. And if you ask me to, daddy's gonna buy you a mockingbird. I'ma give you the world. I'ma buy a diamond ring for you. I'ma sing for you. I'll do anything for you to see you smile.
Reach the voicemail of Gabriel Agreste's office. Please leave a message.
Hi father, it's me. It's parents career day at school, remember? I was hoping that you were gonna show up. Call me back.
You okay?
Yeah, whatever. Nothing new.
And I'm sick of waiting patiently for someone that won't even arrive.
Real life. Sure, as soon as Ladybug shows up, he throws himself at her feet with roses and big declarations. But he gets blown off every time because Ladybug thinks he's obnoxious, and she's right.
When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever.
Just fucking leave me alone.
Mowgli, because you're special and I'm special.
We're not special! Don't you get it? We'll never be one of them. We're freaks! You're not special, Boot! It's just something your mother tells you to make you feel better about yourself because you came out wrong!
Maybe because you never talked to me about anything.
No, I don't love you anymore.
I had a dream, and it scared me. In my dream, you went someplace far away. So far, I wasn't gonna be able to see you again, and everyone forgot about me.
I stay awake at night because I don't even know what my favorite color is, and I'm afraid I don't have a real personality.
Now you're breaking more than my heart, marinette!
What?
What did you say?
Yeah.
scared, and so was I. What if it happened to you on a different day, on a bridge where there wasn't a rail in the way, or a neighborhood street where the little kids play, or the Angeles crest in the snow or the rain? What if you weren't alone, there were kids in the car? What if you were remote, no one knows where you are? If you changed anything, would you not have survived? You're alive, you're alive, you're alive.
She best than I did like a pogo go. Fortnite, going solo. Fucking that bitch, I'm going slow-mo. Walk you like a dog. Walk you like a dog.
Fact is, Walter White couldn't have done it without me.
Since I met him. When Mom disappeared, Father changed. He wouldn't leave the house. I didn't have many friends, except Chloe. Then all of a sudden, I wasn't allowed to go to her place or anywhere else without my bodyguard.
Everything you need is right here where I can keep an eye on you. I will not have you outside in that dangerous world.
And then, Plague showed up.
Plague, nice to meet you.
And thanks to him, I became Cat Noir.
Claws out. That's how you transform.
Got it. Plague, claws out! Cat Noir can go wherever he wants, whenever he wants to. Can I hitch a ride? And he gets to fight supervillains with the strong... the incredible, the miraculous ladybug.
Not a chance, kitty.
Plague goes everywhere with me. School, fencing classes, photo shoots. We can't be separated for long in case I need to transform. And that's the problem. You see, Plague is kind of a special Kwame. He's out of control. Arrogant?
No way.
Like the genie in the lamp.
I met him once, so he grants wishes. Big deal. I'm way more personable.
He even pretended that he caused the extinction of the dinosaurs. And most importantly, he's completely obsessed with cheese. The smellier, the better, if you ask Plagg. His guilty pleasure is camembert. He'd do anything for camembert. Also, he's super lazy. Every time we have to go on a mission, it's the same. It's the only time I get to be myself, meet Ladybug, and save Paris with her. But Plagg always comes up with an excuse not to move a muscle.
We gotta transform now, Plagg.
I thought I was gonna be a spectator, not a performer.
If I listened to him, we'd spend our days eating camembert and watching TV. But in spite of his flaws, I'm glad to have him in my life. Plagg is always here when things get tough.
You okay?
And he's the only one I can tell all about my double life or talk to about Ladybug.
How can you possibly be in love with Ladybug? You don't even know who she really is.
He loves teasing me about it. Deep down, I know he's right. Ladybug and I must keep our identity secret. It's part of being a superhero. But a boy can dream, right? Anyway, I don't know why I was chosen to become Cat Noir, or why Plagg came to me, but I can't picture my life without him anymore. He's allowing me to live my lives to the fullest. All 9 of them.
Come on, let's have a little fun while your father's away.
All right. I'm gonna try and find a nice piece of camembert for him. I think his birthday's coming soon. I wonder what Aquami's birthday looks like. Don't worry, I'll tell you all about it. See you later.